to join me in prayer. We come together, God, joining hands and hearts. Today, God, we create a new community. We forge a new relationship as another graduating class is honored and set free. Today, though leaving this place, we clasp our hands into links of chain which hold our lives together through the bond of a common experience. Not a chain of bondage, but an ivy branch of strength, a bond of love and faith and community, giving us slack to sail the wind, yet holding us tethered in relationship, because this class has joined the chain of Eureka that spans a century and a half and more. Join us, God, and let your spirit and the human spirit awakened by this college flow in each one and through us all as we gather here and as we walk together from this place on a fresh journey. Each spirit here speaks your name from deep within to be with us now. Amen. You may be seated.
Chairman Adams and fellow trustees, distinguished guests, especially our keynote speaker, Joe Scarborough, and our honorary degree recipient, Christine Bonati Bollwinkle, members of our Golden E class celebrating the 50th anniversary of their graduation in 1963. Eureka faculty, staff, and administrators, including our retired staff and our emeriti professors, our cherished alums, friends of the college, the very, very proud family and friends of the class of 2013, and most especially the graduates that comprise the class of 2013. Welcome one and all to the 2013 Eureka College Commencement Ceremony, the 152nd commencement in college history. I would be remiss if I did not thank all who made our campus look so beautiful today. It is no small task to stage this ceremony. Thanks to you all who made the campus so beautiful, those who kept us nourished in body and spirit, and perhaps most importantly on a day like today, those who kept us organized. Class of 2013, you are among the largest graduating classes in Eureka College history, but you will be fondly remembered for your outstanding qualities as individuals and for your leadership as a senior class, as one of the best graduating classes in the life of the college. Ladies and gentlemen, before we proceed with our commencement ceremony, I have a very important announcement. During the 8 years of my presidency, the college has invested in improving our campus, including most recently $10 million to build a new residence hall, Ivy Hall, and renovate all other residence halls. But literally from day one of my presidency, there has been a building project in search of a champion, a lead investor, a benefactor, and that is Venom Binkley Science Hall. One cannot overstate the importance of the addition to Venom Binkley and what it will do in terms of renovating classrooms and adding 11 instructional units, including one laboratory and 8 new classrooms. Literally, this project will update every square foot of a building that will be 100 years old in 2016. Class of 2013, as you commence with your lives today with your Eureka degree in hand, I am pleased to announce that the dream for the addition and expansion of our science building just received a very special gift. And this is no ordinary gift. This gift is larger than any gift in college history. The gift totals $3 million, and what makes this gift perhaps the most special is that it comes from a retired faculty member, a professor emeritus of history, who is with us today. Will Dr. Richard Sanders please stand up and receive our gratitude for your extraordinary gift?
It is now my distinct privilege to announce the winner of the Helen Cleaver Distinguished Teacher Award. The Helen Cleaver Distinguished Teaching Award recognizes excellence, creativity, and innovation in classroom teaching. The award is named for Helen Cleaver, class of 1928, who went on to a distinguished teaching career and supported the college throughout her life. The recipient is Eureka College's Teacher of the Year. This year's winner has had a profound impact on Eureka College and the surrounding community. In the words of one nominator, this faculty member, quote, truly gets students to think deeply about science and to question their assumptions about the way the world works. An extraordinarily innovative teacher, this professor has constantly explored creative ways to get students engaged in her field. One student nominator wrote that this person, quote, would often start class with a song, and based on the homework questions we had answered the night before, we would have to deduce the song, how the song was relevant to the subject matter we were covering. This professor had students act out in class the way cells work and assign different parts of a cell to each group and had them debate which was the most important part. In a nomination letter signed by eight of her students, which is something I've never seen before, they wrote that her Students have been fortunate to have her not only as a professor, but as an advisor. Her encouragement and guidance has allowed them to develop leadership skills and help make a positive impact on their community. They sum up their nomination letter by saying, "She has been an amazing inspiration and undoubtedly changed the outcome of our college careers and our lives. She's been an outstanding ambassador for the college and the community. In the fall, students in her class developed a survey and canvassed residents in Eureka to determine whether or not they would support curbside recycling. This semester, her students partnered with the Eureka High School Science Club to create a video encouraging people to recycle old electronics. And because of her advocacy, there are now signs on Route 117 guiding people to the recycling center in town. She's a committed teacher, an inspiring mentor, and a powerful force for good at Eureka College and in the surrounding community. The winner of this year's Helen Cleaver Distinguished Teaching Award and our speaker for the August 2013 opening convocation is Dr. Renee Mullen, Assistant Professor of Environmental Studies."
As a philanthropist, Christine Bonati Bollwinkle played a pivotal role in the turnaround and resurgence of Eureka College during the past decade, and she continues to inspire others to give today. In 2007, her $1 million gift to Eureka to honor her late husband Ron and her dear friend Joe Finch was the largest gift in the history of the college at that time. Both Ron and Joe were alums of the college. Ron played football at Eureka and was a member of the Teak fraternity. He served on the Eureka College Board of Trustees, and he was a vice president with Caterpillar. Joe loved music and the arts and was a member of the Delta Delta Pi sorority. Christine's gift supported a much, and I mean much needed, new fitness center at the Reagan Center, and two sets of scholarships named in honor of Ron and Joe. It cannot be overstated how important and impactful these gifts were at the time and continue to be transformational today. For example, our graduating class of 2013 has always had the benefit of the Bonati Fitness Center. As important as the gift was to Eureka, Christine took on another role with our students, sharing why she gave her transformational gift in an article published in our student newspaper, The Pegasus. Quoting from that article, quote, "I believe our approach to money and possessions is an important to our spiritual lives. My giving is a response to the grace of God in my life," close quote. Christine, a little did you know at the time a professor of history read your article, especially the part about giving while you are living so you can see the results of your generosity. For her leadership giving and her efforts to inspire others to give, Christine Bonati Bollwinkle received the 2008 Central Illinois Outstanding Philanthropist Award from the Association of Fundraising Professionals. In 2010, Mrs. B joined Ron and Joe as Eureka College alumni when she was named by the Alumni Board and the Board of Trustees as an honorary alumna of Eureka College. Chairman Adams and Dr. Cavalier, please escort Mrs. Bollwinkle to the podium. Christine Bonati Bollwinkle, it is my privilege now, on behalf of the trustees and the faculty of Eureka College, and with the authority vested in me by the charter granted in 1855 by the legislature of the state of Illinois, to confer upon you the honorary degree of Doctor of Humane Letters with all the rights and privileges thereunto appertaining.
Thank you. President Arnold said I had to say a few words, so a few words is it. It is just an amazing honor to receive this kind of recognition. It's just been a privilege to become familiar with Eureka College, to witness all the wonderful things that the college has accomplished. And so for that very reason, I will continue to support Eureka College. May God bless Eureka College and all those who enter its doors. Thank you.
Eureka College is pleased to welcome Joe Scarborough as our 2013 commencement keynote speaker. Some of you simply know him as Morning Joe by the title of his popular news broadcast he hosts with Mika Brzezinski every weekday morning on MSNBC from 5 to 8 a.m. Or perhaps you know Mr. Scarborough from his earlier public service as a member of the U.S. Congress from 1994 to 2001. Mr. Scarborough was part of the famous Republican freshman class elected that year. Joe is the father of four children. I hope you will understand that as appreciative as the class of 2013 is about having you as their commencement speaker, they may be a bit fuzzy about your congressional career as they were toddlers at the time. And I'm going to go out on a limb here. As a father of four children, I'm sure, Joe, you know that the probability that college students are up on a regular basis at 5 a.m. is not likely. So for all of you, including members of the class of 2013, let me tell you a little bit about the Morning Joe show. Each weekday morning, Morning Joe brings together panels of writers, analysts, and political leaders to discuss the news of the day, interspersing video clips, including my favorite, humor from late night TV shows. Because if you're up watching Morning Joe, you weren't the night prior watching Leno or Letterman. So I appreciate being able to catch up. The show's noteworthy guests create a mix of political opinions, news analysis, and reporting on current events. In many respects, the Morning Joe program resembles a seminar class at a liberal arts college where critical thinking, debate, and analysis are informed by data and a diversity of opinions. In fact, when the show works as designed, Morning Joe illustrates the way civil discourse and civic engagement works best in America, the type of discourse that Ronald Wilson Reagan himself would endorse and embrace. Joe Scarborough was born in Atlanta, Georgia. He attended the University of Alabama for his undergraduate studies and remains an ardent fan of the Crimson Tide. Mr. Scarborough earned a law degree from the University of Florida College of Law, and he practiced law in the private sector before entering politics. As a congressman, he represented the 1st District of Florida. Joe is married to Susan, and they live in Connecticut, which is the, of course, nearby the home production area of New York for Morning Joe. But he continues to keep close to his family roots in Pensacola and Western Florida. While this is Mr. Scarborough's first visit to campus, earlier this academic year, he could be seen on campus via Skype as one of the more than dozen participants in the Reagan 101 course taught by visiting Reagan scholar Craig Shirley. And Joe and co-host Mika also attended last year's Honorary Reagan Fellow Dinner in New York City for Secretary James A. Baker III. But today, he has finally made it in person to experience his own Eureka moment. For all his achievements as a broadcast journalist and as a conservative commentator, and sparking debates, discussions that are necessary for the gears of democracy to turn, in 2011, he was named to Time's 100 list as one of the most influential people in the world. Ladies and gentlemen, please give a warm Eureka welcome to Joe Scarborough.
Do you have an Auburn fan? War Eagle.
Thank you so much for being here, and I can assure you that nobody that voted on the Time 100 list is from the Central Time Zone and would have to wake up at 5 a.m. to watch me. Only my mother does that. So, President Arnold, thank you so much for having me here. Chairman Adams, Christine, thank you for your generosity. Professor, thank you as well. My goodness, you sure do pay professors well at Eureka College. I want to hear that story someday. I also want to thank Dr. Henry. The music was beautiful. I grew up in a Southern Baptist church in the Deep South, and at the end of every service, I would hear that arrangement. And it took me back to those days growing up in the Baptist church. And right before we left the service, looked at our watches and made sure that it ended exactly at noon so we'd be first in line at Morrison's. Thank you for those memories. What a great honor it is to be standing here today in front of all of you before Eureka College's graduating class of 2013. I liked how the Reverend said, "We honor you and we free you." Has a good ring to it, doesn't it? I am awed, I really am, by the legacy that binds this special place to some of our country's greatest achievements over the last century. But today, I'm a lot more excited to be talking to a group of people, the men and women of the class of 2013 that have in their hands the ability to help define the outlines of the next great American century. As much as I love Ronald Reagan, as much as I honor him, as much as he influenced my life, and he did in so many ways, I've come here today not to pay homage to that great past or the great past of this college, but instead to address a class that has the ability to bend history in the future. Now, this isn't a responsibility I undertook lightly. I usually don't have a lot of people counseling me, but for this special event, I made sure I spoke with the great communicators around the great communicator, Craig Shirley, who you mentioned, a man who I am sure has written another biography of Ronald Reagan in the time it has taken me to deliver this introduction. Craig told me to make sure that I focused on the glories of Reagan's character. My dear friend Pat Buchanan, he suggested that I address the ominous clouds that now hang low over Western civilization. And Peggy Noonan, perhaps the most eloquent speechwriter of our time, Peggy reminded me in no uncertain terms that I am the only thing that is standing between you and your first celebratory beer, so keep it short, Buster. And I will. It is perhaps a warning that your biggest applause line is when you give it the promise to keep it short. So let me speak quickly. It is important to cling to your faith. Faith in yourself, faith in your country, and faith in your God. We live in a self-absorbed age, the me generation that Thomas Wolfe wrote of when he was talking about the baby boomers, a generation that gave us such culturally destructive forces as Woodstock, disco, polyester, Wall Street greed, and Bill Clinton, has now given way to the culture phenomenons of Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and Snapchat. You may want to explain to your parents after this why you want those videos to disappear so quickly, but we'll talk about that later. As Time Magazine reported this week, the me generation of the baby boomers has given way to the me generation. It is a generation where every human emotion can be reduced to 140 characters, where every smile becomes captive to a smartphone snapshot, where every mundane task becomes fodder for a Facebook posting. Please, let the word go forth from this day forward. I don't care what your aunt's grocery list looks like, and I don't want to know how your roommate did in fantasy baseball last week. These are things that we can all keep to ourselves. But you, and I'm very serious here, because I do tell my four children, you want to rule the world? Read a book. You have got to shield yourself in the coming years from the blizzard of unrelenting, useless information and ceaseless interactions that interrupt your life every 14 seconds. You have got to find time every week to escape from this frantic, self-centered age that you have been born into and look to find meaning beyond yourself. Faith in the God that was revealed in the Sermon on the Mount is the perfect antidote to the me-ism of our time. A faith focused instead on being merciful, on being humble, on being kind, and doing unto others as you would have them do to you. But even beyond those beatitudes, a faith in God will serve as a buffer against the kind of self-absorption that will make your existence empty and unfulfilling. Cling also to your faith in this great country of ours. Despite all the overwhelming challenges that we face today, and the challenges do seem great, but I've got to tell you, it seems hard to imagine a time more grim or difficult in this country than when Ronald Reagan was sworn in on January 20th, 1981. Interest rates were over 20%. The Soviet Union was on the march. We had been humiliated in the eyes of the world by the Iranian hostage crisis for 444 days. And most alarmingly, too many Americans had stopped believing in themselves and stopped believing in this great republic. Ronald Reagan, one man, bent history. He changed everything because Reagan believed in the greatness of America. And as I was driving into this town, and I was walking across this campus, I understood why. It's like Tocqueville said, America is great because America is good. And when America ceases to be good, it will cease
to be great. You see that goodness in Eureka. You see that goodness across America. Ronald Reagan did then, and I do today. Faith in America, and it all started here, was the Gipper's guiding light. It wasn't the punchline in a political speech. And that made all the difference in the world. Reagan liked to quote another Illinois native, Carl Sandburg, who said, "I see America not in the setting sun of a black night of despair ahead of us. I see America in the crimson light of a rising sun, fresh from the burning, creative hand of God. I see great days ahead, great days possible to men and women of will and vision." You know, a few years after becoming president, during an era of malaise, Ronald Reagan told a re-energized America, "We can perform great deeds and take freedom's next step, and we will. We will carry on the tradition of a good and worthy people who have brought light where there was darkness, warmth where there was cold, medicine where there was hunger, and peace where there was only bloodshed. Let us be sure that those who come after will say of us in our time that in our time we did everything that could be done. We finished the race. We kept them free, and we kept the faith." You know, within 5 years, the Berlin Wall, which sits outside a part of it now in a garden, was torn down. The Soviet Empire was in ruins, and 100 million souls had finally been freed from the tyranny of communism. Reagan's critics had been scornful of this Eureka College grad who kept talking about his optimism in America. Some had even predicted World War III. He was a saber rattler. He was jingoistic. He was going to provoke the Soviets into war. Instead, Ronald Reagan's policies gave Americans a sudden end to a twilight struggle that once had grimly held the possibility of a Holocaust. In less than a decade's time, Ronald Reagan's faith in America, his faith in America and its greatness, had paid off. And it's now your time to continue that race, to keep them free, and to keep the faith, your faith in God, your faith in country, and most importantly, your faith in yourself. Because it never gets easier. It never got easier for Ronald Reagan. It's never got easier for me. Let me tell you, I decided to run for Congress when I was 29 years old. Nobody knew who I was. I had no money. I had no name ID. I had no connections. I just had the belief that I had to go to Washington and make America a better place. To tell you the truth, when I knocked on doors, people would say, "Why are you running for Congress?" And I'd say, "Because I want to stop Bill Clinton." I'd see that guy on TV and be like, "I feel your pain." I'd go, "He's lying. You know he's lying." And so when I told my parents that I was going to run against Earl Hutto, a 16-year incumbent in a district that hadn't elected a Republican since 1872, and they had hung the last one they sent up to Washington. It was a tough town. They call it the Redneck Riviera, Northwest Florida, L.A., Lower Alabama, AA, America's Albania. I can go on forever. I went to tell my parents that I was going to run against Earl Hutto because I wanted to stop what was happening in Washington. I thought they'd be excited, right? First of all, they're my parents. I'm entitled to that excitement, right? Secondly, my parents are so conservative, they still think Richard Nixon was framed. So I remember telling my mom and dad in their kitchen, "Mom, Dad, I'm running against Earl Hutto." My dad stared at me, looked down for about 5 minutes, put his hands in his pocket, looked up, and then he said, and I'll remember this as long as I live because my dad passed away a couple years ago. He said, "That's great, Joey, but I'm voting for Earl." Seriously? Right? Seriously? I turned to my mom. I go, "Ma, who's weeping in the corner? Help me here." She says, "I'll vote for you." So I figure, being the optimist, I learned it from the best. Here I am campaigning in a district that hadn't elected a Republican since 1872. I have no money, no name ID. I'm running against a 16-year incumbent in the first house I ran in. I split it right down the middle, 50-50. And I found that year you didn't need your father's vote to win. So I got 62% of the vote, and I went to Washington. But you know what? You would think that would be affirmation. In Congress by 30. I had a TV show by the time I was 40. And even then, I'm in New York City, and I have three strikes against me. I'm conservative, I'm from the South, and I went to a state school, the University of Alabama, and we have an Auburn fan here. I thought you were dressing kind of goofy for Central Illinois, but anyway. People in Manhattan made fun of me because of my alma mater, Alabama. I admit it, I wasn't good in math, but as you know very well, at Alabama, you don't have to be good in math because every year we only have to count to number one. Anyway, roll tide! Roll tide! I don't know if we have any Notre Dame fans in the audience, but my condolences. I just want to assure you that in the Southeast, we play real football and have real girlfriends. Is there a back entrance here, by the way? Ronald Reagan, too. I'm going to go back to my safe zone now. Ronald Reagan as well. You know, one of my favorite speeches Ronald Reagan gave, or at least part of a speech that Ronald Reagan gave, was at a commencement, which, by the way, he borrowed from his 1982 speech at Eureka College at the commencement there. He went to Harvard, where professors had been mocking him as an amiable dunce for years that didn't have a good enough education to run this country. Reagan stood in front of them. He had the seal of the president right there as he talked to him, and he talked to the Harvard grads and the faculty that sat behind him who had no respect for him or his education, and he said, "You know, sometimes I lie awake in bed at night and I wonder just what I would have accomplished if I had a good education." Remember that. Ronald Reagan didn't have a good education. He had a great education. As I drove in today, as I sat through this ceremony, and as I look at this graduating class that walked through the class of 2013, I can tell you that you didn't have a good education here over your 4 years. You had a great education. So cling to your faith. Cling to your faith in God. Cling to your faith in this great country of ours. Cling to your faith in yourself. And if you do, you will find, like President Reagan, that even in this cynical, self-absorbed age, you can help others, you can make a difference in this country, and you can bend history in this world. So go out now and bend history. Thank you so much.
Good morning. Because as President Arnold said so well, yeah, we really don't get up at 5 a.m. This is about prime time right now. So my name is Myles Philipp, and as senior class president, I have the honor to represent the senior class during this special occasion. Before I begin, I would like to say a few much-deserved thank yous. First, I would like to thank Morning Joe Scarborough for delivering the commencement address and taking his time to share this occasion with all of us. And as he was giving his speech, I was just thinking how many people were hashtagging the word Morning Joe, you know, and then just stopped dead after he started. Next, I want to thank the faculty of Eureka College. As a student, I hear a lot of good and bad about Eureka College, but something you never hear bad about Eureka is the faculty. Unless, of course, someone failed the class or didn't like a grade they received. Nonetheless, we as students are fortunate enough to have a group of faculty that goes above and beyond, inside and outside the classroom for us each and every day. I've heard countless stories over my 4 years here where professors have gone above and beyond to help a student in need. I have also seen professors get involved outside of the classroom and make special connections with the students, be it intramural basketball, homecoming, or organizations that they advise. I also want to thank the staff here at Eureka College. I know from talking to some of my friends who go to bigger schools, they can never understand how I knew so many staff members and how I taught to so many of them weekly. Yeah, we are a smaller school, and it is easier to get to know the students, but I know the staff here enjoys that part of the job and has always made the extra effort to talk to students to see how they were doing. I always wondered how they got any work done with students always in and out of their offices, and trust me, I know I was definitely one to blame for that. Lastly, I want to thank all the family members, friends, and other individuals who have come to share this day with us. It means a lot to us that you are here, and we are thankful for the support that you have given us. I especially want to thank the parents in the audience who are able to come and be here today. I know we haven't always called as much as we should have. I also know a lot of times we probably didn't see eye to eye. Believe me, though, when I tell you, we are grateful for everything you have done for us. Some of us might even want to make up for lost time, and if our room is still available at home, we might just move back in. I think we owe you that much for being gone the last 4 years. Now, as I look around, I see a lot of familiar faces. When I took my first visit to Eureka College, they told me the student population here was different. I didn't believe them, but after the 5-minute tour of campus, I could tell something here was different about this school. It wasn't that I saw people running around campus with Nerf guns playing humans versus zombies. No, that came later in my college career. The thing that was different was that the student body here was one big family. Yeah, a lot of us had to do with the fact that we are, like I said earlier, a smaller campus, and we don't have a choice on how well we have to know each other. But we are one huge family, especially the senior class graduating right now. I know as I continue on with my speech, it is bittersweet. Don't get me wrong, I can't wait to finish my speech soon so I can get out of here and go celebrate the day. What is bittersweet, though, is once I finish this speech, a lot of us will be saying our last goodbyes. As much as I would love for all of us to stay in Eureka and never move away, I think a lot of us have different plans. While it is hard to give this speech and know that this is the last time we will ever talk, I do hope that we take a chance before we think back about our years here at Eureka College. I'm not going to sit here and say it was all great, because I know we had our struggles, but it is in both the good times and bad times that we make up our story. I know us well, whether we want to admit it or not, we have learned a lot over the years here, both academically and socially. I know I learned to be patient, especially when it comes to the internet here. I also learned to always prepare for the worst, like knowing where every printer is on campus in case you only have 10 minutes to print that paper that is due, and the first couple spots you don't check or don't work. And most of all, I learned to be accepting of everyone, because we are all weird in our own special ways, and the greatest skill we can take away from college is knowing how to work with a wide range of individuals. I also hope we learn the skills academically that will help us with our future careers. Eureka College gave us the ability to learn inside and outside of the classroom, and just this April brought Justice Sandra Day O'Connor to campus, which many of us were lucky enough to witness. For everyone graduating, I think the point when you know it's about over comes at a different time. For some, it came when senioritis hit back in August, and for some, it won't come until they wake up tomorrow morning and they can't call Eureka home anymore. It didn't hit me for a long time, but when it finally did, the only thing I could think about was how far we have all come. I look back at my freshman year and realize how much each and every one of us has changed and how much Eureka College has changed with us. 4 years ago, this school looked a lot different. Upper Deweese and Upper Myers housed students. The new Ivy building was just an idea, and freshman seminar was only taken for one credit instead of three. And the commons food? Okay, the food hasn't changed much, but you get the idea. I like to think that Eureka has changed, as we as students have also changed. We have grown these last 4 years since the day we dropped our Ivy and the welcome week convocation. I can say from experience that we have all grown since freshman year, hopefully wiser, more educated, and a little less socially awkward. I hope that every one of us who is graduating here today, if we haven't done so already, reflects on our time here at Eureka College. As we reflect, though, there are many students here at Eureka College who are still writing their stories. So it is with that amazing transition of thought that I ask the next senior class president for the following academic year, Cody Leach, to step up here. As Eureka tradition follows, I present you first with the ceremonial shovel. There you go. And next, I will present you with the ceremonial chains. These are long, so have fun. Yes, they are heavy. So I present you with these in help in your search for the rum cake buried somewhere on this campus. Second, I give you a poem of clues that will help you in your search of the rum cake. I actually forgot it, sorry. We'll hook up later, trust me. With that, I wish you the best of luck, not only in your search for the rum cake, because I didn't tell you that you only graduate if you find the rum cake, right? Have fun, junior class. But the best of luck to you and every student who is still calling Eureka College home. Thank you. And you gotta take those with you. Don't leave them up here. Everyone graduating today is going to take a different path in life, and that is a great thing. While we all might have a different journey, we will always have one thing in common that we can never forget. We are all graduates of Eureka College. Because of this, we must all remember where we come from, no matter how far we might have traveled away. I say this because as I end my speech, I hope we are ending our connection with Eureka College and our connection to the group that we graduate with today. I hope that no matter where each of us goes in life, we all take a little time back and come back as alumni and say hello. Our years here at Eureka College have changed each and every one of us, whether we want to admit it or not. So I'm going to end my speech by saying good luck to us, the Eureka College graduating class of 2013, and not goodbye, but see you later. And I hope we have a few good stories to share when we do.
I'm not sure Joe knew that I get to come back up here. So two housekeeping items. First of all, I'm a native New Yorker, and I just want to confirm that Joe did indeed have three strikes against him when he went to New York City. And the second thing is, it is fortunate that Alabama is a good football team because they can't count past one.
Roll Tide!
War Eagle. We've now come to the conferring of the degrees to the class of 2013. All degrees have been subject to actual completion of course requirements, verification by Dean Wignall, and voted confirmation by the faculty and Board of Trustees.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Eureka College class of 2013 consists of 186 graduates. 40 of these will graduate today with a Bachelor of Arts degree. 146 will graduate with a Bachelor of Science degree. The top five majors in the class of 2013, at number five, tied at number five, History and Political Science with 12 graduates, Psychology with 12 graduates. In fourth place, tied, Criminal Justice Sociology with 14 graduates, kinesiology with 14. Third place, communication, 18 graduates. Elementary education, second place with 28. Number one, business administration with 34 graduates. 21 students in the class of 2013 graduated with a double major. Two students graduated with a triple major. 28 students today graduate with teacher certification. One student graduates today having completed the Eureka College Honors Program. 60 students in the class of 2013 will graduate with academic honors today. 18 of them will graduate cum laude, having attained a Eureka College cumulative grade point average of between 3.5 and 3.69. 18 will graduate magna cum laude, having attained a Eureka College cumulative grade point average of between 3.7 and 3.89. And today, 24 graduates will graduate having attained a Eureka College cumulative grade point average of between 3.9 and 3.40, graduating summa cum laude. Of these 24 graduates, 13 of them graduated with a perfect 4.0.
Will the 2013 candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Arts and Bachelor of Science please rise? President Arnold, these candidates have successfully pursued their courses of study prescribed by the faculty of Eureka College for the degrees of Bachelor of Arts and Bachelor of Science. Upon the affirmative votes of the faculty and Board of Trustees, I present them to you to receive their degrees.
My friends of the class of 2013, it is now my honor and privilege, on behalf of the trustees and the faculty of Eureka College, and with the authority vested in me by the charter granted in 1855 by the legislature of the state of Illinois, to confer upon each of you, as befitting by the record of your academic accomplishment, the degree of Bachelor of Arts or Bachelor of Science, with all the rights and privileges thereunto appertaining. You may now switch your tassels, and we invite you to come forward individually to receive your diploma. Congratulations.
Dr. Junius Rodriguez, Chair of the Social Science and Business Division, and filling in at the moment for Dr. Jessica Barr, the Director of the Honors Program. We have one student this year who has completed all the requirements of the Honors Program, which includes researching, writing, and presenting an honors thesis. That student is Michael Logan Salee, Bachelor of Science, summa cum laude. This is an important weekend for the Salee family. Michael's mother, Kathy, graduated from Eureka College 30 years ago, and his grandmother, Dorothy, graduated from Eureka College 60 years ago. Would they please stand and acknowledge?
Good morning. My name's Jim Miller. I'm a chair of the Education Division. It's my pleasure to introduce to you the graduates of 2013 in the Education Division. Murad Atala Abdullah, Bachelor of Science. Carson William Andrew, Bachelor of Science, magna cum laude. Daniel Augustus Bolson, Bachelor of Science, cum laude. Michelle Ann Boschek, Bachelor of Science, summa cum laude. Pamela Sue Brasher, Bachelor of Science. Cassandra Christine Brown, Bachelor of Science, cum laude. Lauren Michelle Bruck, Bachelor of Science, cum laude. Blake Matthew Chapman, Bachelor of Science. Bridget Ann Davis, Bachelor of Science. Carrie Lynn Diller, Bachelor of Science. Sarah Lynette Eberly, Bachelor of Science. Brittany Elizabeth Fager, Bachelor of Science. Jacqueline Elaine Flanagan, Bachelor of Science, summa cum laude. Pierce Adam Furrow, Bachelor of Science. Kelsey Lynn Garou, Bachelor of Science. Lindsay M. Glob, Bachelor of Science, magna cum laude. Elizabeth Ann Greger, Bachelor of Science. Caitlin Marie Gross, Bachelor of Science, summa cum laude. Megan Nicole Harvey, Bachelor of Science, cum laude. Rachel Elizabeth Hostetler, Bachelor of Science, summa cum laude. Carrie Anna Engel, Bachelor of Science. Jamie Pauline Johnson, Bachelor of Science. Taylor K. Jones, Bachelor of Science. Alicia Marie Kernan, Bachelor of Science, magna cum laude. Kayla Beth Keppel, Bachelor of Science. Rebecca Ann Colvite, receiving her degree, will be her brother, Tim. Ethan David Lord, Bachelor of Science. Robert Eugene Mann, Bachelor of Science. Alicia Ray McCormick, Bachelor of Science, magna cum laude. Catherine Marie McLaughlin, Bachelor of Science. Haley Marie Alexiak, Bachelor of Science, cum laude. Elizabeth Ann Rassi, Bachelor of Science, magna cum laude. Megan Elizabeth Reince, Bachelor of Science, summa cum laude. Luke David Seidel, Bachelor of Science, summa cum laude. Marissa Rakisha May Schweitzer, Bachelor of Science. Tommy Lee Tapper, Bachelor of Science. Kylie Ann Teal, Bachelor of Science. Lainey Marie Vitti, Bachelor of Science. Joshua Joe Wagner, Bachelor of Science. Kayla Marie Walden, Bachelor of Arts, summa cum laude. Rayanne Michelle Younger, Bachelor of Science.
Good morning. I'm Rhea Edge, Chair of Fine and Performing Arts, presenting our graduates. Jared Thomas Barth, Bachelor of Arts. Tyler K. Bishop, Bachelor of Science. Melissa Jean Clements, Bachelor of Arts, magna cum laude. Christine Elizabeth Funk, Bachelor of Arts. Benjamin William Hall, Bachelor of Arts. Brianna Sue Sorensen, Bachelor of Arts, cum laude.
Good morning, I'm Dr. Mike Thurwanger. I'm chairman of the Humanities Division. I want to join in congratulating this year's class, and I'll now announce the graduates from the Humanities Division. Kelsey Joe Olig, Bachelor of Arts. Courtney Paige Bates, Bachelor of Arts. Blake Edward Baxter, Bachelor of Arts. Samantha Susan Boone, Bachelor of Arts. Wynn Taylor Burkett, Bachelor of Arts. Erin Marie Cochran, Bachelor of Arts. Douglas Owen Collins, Bachelor of Arts, cum laude. Jonathan Anton Helgeson, Bachelor of Arts. Rebecca Ann Idell, Bachelor of Arts. Jordan Lee Jefferson, Bachelor of Arts. Carolyn Joy Knoll, Bachelor of Arts. Lydia Ray Presley, Bachelor of Arts, summa cum laude. Shelby Lynn Rogers, Bachelor of Arts. Megan Elizabeth Santman, Bachelor of Arts. And Jamie Ann Weber, Bachelor of Arts.
Good morning, I'm Dr. Small, Chair of Math and Science. I'd just like to say thank you very much to Dick Sanders for his generous gift for the Sanders Hall and Venn and Binkley renovation. I'm very proud to recognize the following graduates. Bianca Cristel Canciani, Bachelor of Science. Janelle Elizabeth Chapman, Bachelor of Science, summa cum laude. Timothy Jason Caldwell, Bachelor of Science. Deanne Michelle Crook, Bachelor of Science. Justin Edward Dillard, Bachelor of Science. Wendy Lee Ferguson, Bachelor of Science, magna cum laude. Bradley James Gabehart, Bachelor of Science. Brandon Ray Haas, Bachelor of Science.
Brandon Michael Klein, Bachelor of Science, magna cum laude. Alyssa Michelle Neva Martin, Bachelor of Arts, magna cum laude. Danielle Renee Nelson, Bachelor of Science. Kate Elizabeth Aquat, Bachelor of Science. Jessica Lynn Rosenquist, Bachelor of Science. Brandon Michael Rupp, Bachelor of Science. Andrew Ross Shipke, Bachelor of Science. Isaac Andrew Teal, Bachelor of Science, summa cum laude. Bridget Lee Thomas, Bachelor of Science. Stephen J. Tucker, Bachelor of Science. Timothy Edward Umdenstock, Bachelor of Science. Megan Lee Wade, Bachelor of Science. Nicholas Michael Yunker, Bachelor of Science. Brittany Nicole Zimmerman, Bachelor of Science.
Dr. Rodriguez, Chair of the Social Science and Business Division, congratulations to all of today's graduates. I'm pleased to announce the names of the Social Science and Business Division graduates. Valerie Lauren All, Bachelor of Arts. Azize Arzu Arjan, Bachelor of Science, cum laude. Bernard Michael Badgerow, Bachelor of Science, magna cum laude. Monica Michelle Brinkman, Bachelor of Science. Tyler Brandon Chase, Bachelor of Science. Rebecca Kathleen Collins, Bachelor of Science, magna cum laude. Tabitha Sue Cotton, Bachelor of Science. Adam David Crank, Bachelor of Arts, summa cum laude. Eric Jean Cuevas, Bachelor of Science. Jonathan Ryan Diedrich, Bachelor of Science. Andrea Marie Desatnik, Bachelor of Science. Haley Jordan Dorfline, Bachelor of Science. Lisa Leanne Elston, Bachelor of Science. James Jason Enloe, Bachelor of Science, magna cum laude. Kimberly Ann Foley, Bachelor of Science. Justin D. Fair, Bachelor of Science. Erin Sue Force, Bachelor of Science, magna cum laude. William P. Gieske, Bachelor of Arts. Joshua Dean Gerard, Bachelor of Science. Brent Anthony Michael Glass, Bachelor of Arts, cum laude. Michael Eugene Grinninger, Bachelor of Science. Sarah Esmeralda Guerrero, Bachelor of Science. Jessica Lynn Hartley, Bachelor of Science. Nathan Lee Hyderi, Bachelor of Science, summa cum laude. Taryn Jane Heffley, Bachelor of Science. Jenna Ann Heisel, Bachelor of Science, summa cum laude. Lauren Alyssa Heiser, Bachelor of Science, summa cum laude. Holly Lee Henlein, Bachelor of Science, cum laude. Kimoni Theodore Hess, Bachelor of Science. Nathan Kyle Holland, Bachelor of Science. Travis A. Huber, Bachelor of Science. Mitch Martin Johnson, Bachelor of Science, cum laude. Angela M. Jones, Bachelor of Science, cum laude. Hannah Lee Jones, Bachelor of Science. Alexander Lucas Jordan, Bachelor of Science. Jordan Craig Kindred, Bachelor of Science. Hillary Whitney Codet, Bachelor of Science, summa cum laude. Cheryl Ann Langley, Bachelor of Science. Mark Andrew Lesson, Bachelor of Science. Chardonnay Alexiana Lopez, Bachelor of Science. Grant Edward Madden, Bachelor of Arts. Gabriela Martinez, Bachelor of Science. Ryan Michael Matlock, Bachelor of Science. Brandon James McSheffrey, Bachelor of Science. Charles Nicholas Mizoraka, Bachelor of Science. Kyle Jeffrey Oyer, Bachelor of Science. Megan Margaret Francis Pala, Bachelor of Science. Michael Stephen Petrovich, Bachelor of Arts. Myles Robert Philipp, Bachelor of Science, cum laude. Christopher Douglas Robinson, Bachelor of Science, summa cum laude. James Joseph Rule, Bachelor of Science, summa cum laude. Tiffany Lauren Schertz, Bachelor of Science. Casey Marie Schumacher, Bachelor of Arts, summa cum laude. Reginald Franklin Say II, Bachelor of Science, magna cum laude. Stephen Michael Snyder, Bachelor of Science. Sherry Lynn Steidinger, Bachelor of Science, cum laude. Meredith Kathleen Tuttle, Bachelor of Arts, magna cum laude. Kelly Jo Vietti, Bachelor of Science. John Allen Ward, Bachelor of Science. Danielle Nicole Warner, Bachelor of Science, magna cum laude. Drake Edward Webster, Bachelor of Science. Keith Allen White, Bachelor of Science. Craig Michael Wilson, Bachelor of Science. Colin James Wolfe, Bachelor of Arts. David Ray Yeager, Bachelor of Science.
Let's have a round of congratulations again for all our graduates.
I'm Makisha Armstrong, and I would like to be the first to welcome you into a small but very prestigious group to the 2013 graduating class of Eureka College. Welcome to the Eureka College Alumni Association. Being counted as one of Eureka's 5,083 graduates, our alumni are spread all across the U.S. and the world, as far as Japan and as near as Eureka, Illinois. As an alum, you are charged with doing three things: keeping the spirit of Eureka College alive, checking in with the college, and coming back home. During your 4 years, the college has emphasized the importance to learn, lead, and serve. So as you transition into this next phase of your life, you will continue to learn. Life is a journey, and you will undoubtedly begin to learn how to apply those things that you have been taught here at Eureka College. There are numerous leadership positions that were available at Eureka, and I know that many of you were engaged in one or more of those opportunities. And in the future, whether you are recognized as a leader of an organization, of a project, or of your family, you will undoubtedly go on to make a difference in whatever capacity that you lead. The foundation of the Eureka College spirit, however, is the ability to serve others in their time of need and make a positive impact on their lives. You were able to partake in numerous serving capacities as a student. So think about it. What would happen if no one served in the capacity of helping the hungry, volunteering at the Red Cross during disasters, working as a JFL coach, making contributions to the nonprofit organizations, making contributions to the college to provide grant and scholarship opportunities to make attending college an achievable goal, to make graduating from college a reality? Would you be here if no one gave of their time, their treasure, or their talent? Would you be here if no one served? Some say the more you give, the more you receive. But to take a passage out of the Bible, which is the best-selling book of all times, when you give, it will be given back to you, pressed down, shaken together, and running over. You are charged with giving back and continuing to help others to ultimately make this world a better place. Perhaps you thought your relationship with the college would end after commencement. Well, the difference between Eureka College and many other fine educational institutions is that we want to hear from you. We want to know when you get married, when you have kids, when you land your first job, about that major accomplishment in your life, your promotions and achievements. We have papers on you, and we have rights to brag about you. You are charged with letting us know what you are doing. Eureka College was your home for the last several years, and it will always be your home. Come back to campus when you get engaged. Bring your children, show them your alma mater. Bring your university of whatever college friends and show them that you are not just a number, you are a name. I sat in your seat in 1993, 20 years ago, and when I return to the college each time, it's great to run into old friends and talk to my college professors. And when alumni come home, it provides us with the opportunity to celebrate you. Come back and let us celebrate you. So graduates, mark your calendars for October 4th and 5th. Come back to homecoming. Remember that someone at Eureka College will always be here to welcome you home. Congratulations, class of 2013. May God bless you in your future endeavors.
Now it's time for us to bless our final tradition. Our final ceremony, the ivy ceremony. Would you join me in prayer? Our students have journeyed far in the last 4 years, O God of grace, and the road goes ever on. It's a road that began with their birth, that wound its way through meadows and mountains, that crossed rivers and canyons of experience, highs and lows, when loved ones picked them up and brushed them off and let them go again. And for those moments, we give you thanks, Lord. For the bread that has sustained them on this journey, for the guides who have led them, the family, the friends, faculty, staff, local congregations, we offer thanks and praise, O God. And as our graduates prepare to leave these hallowed halls, memories come rushing back, a mix of gratitude and regrets, sadness and joy, relief and thanksgiving. For friends and memories they've made these last 4 years, Walmart runs and Steak and Shake at 2 a.m., walking around our beautiful campus, the blizzard of 2011, playing in the snow with friends. For this we give thanks. For taking group pictures that include Reagan's bust in the Peace Garden, true brothers and sisters, Greek and independent, helping organizations make a difference, the tree lighting ceremony and the bonfires, walking into Rinker on the memorial bricks as freshmen at opening convocation, and again in cap and gown, we remember those bricks. Pulling all-nighters to write a paper because we put it off for so long. Rich and quirky traditions involving fruitcakes and shovels. And the daily intellectual challenge for the staff and professors who have guided us through these educational process and helping us reach and exceed our goals that we've met today. Help us pray all these memories, spoken and unspoken, lighthearted and heartfelt, into a blessed whole, a living chain that defines our graduates without binding them. For all these things, we give you thanks. Bless this ivy chain, make it strong, and the pieces everlasting that we take with us this day. Amen.
I'd like to ask the graduates to please come and get around the ivy circle. I'd also invite faculty and staff and trustees to stand behind the graduates as they form up in a circle. Thank you. The Ivy ceremony has for generations been a cherished part of Eureka graduations. Ivy shares the nature of vines: strength, flexibility, determination. Perhaps because of these characteristics, and not simply because it is often found on academic buildings, ivy has become associated with learning. Those of us from the college's faculty and staff believe that the educations our graduates earn here contain all these qualities. Ivy is also a bond, a fact clear to anyone who has tried to remove it from where it is not wanted. The circle of ivy bonding us this morning symbolizes the lasting friendships formed in this remarkable learning community. Now we are at a time of parting, represented by the cutting of the ivy circle. In doing so, we acknowledge the inevitable dispersal of commencement and graduation, the close of one passage, the opening of another. As we begin, we remind ourselves of yet one more quality of ivy: its ability to take root elsewhere. As we cut the ivy chain, graduates take their sprigs with them. May those sprigs and all they represent take root within each of us, whatever our travels, thereby spreading the knowledge, the friendships, the love of learning, and the love of learners we have experienced at Eureka College. Please stand and join us now for the singing of the alma mater. And so closes the 152nd commencement of Eureka College. Now that the ivy ceremony is concluded, we are all invited to attend the reception hosted by President and Mrs. Arnold immediately following in the Terrell Room of the Surf Center in honor of our graduates. To the alumni of the class of 2013, to their friends and families, congratulations and all best wishes. Let us go in grace and peace.